If you only had 7 seconds to make someone trust you, believe in you, or vote for you, how would you use them? Silvia Giusto. And simply put, when it comes to your first impression and your professional imprint, I've got you covered. Before jumping into today's topic, be sure to subscribe to my channel, connect on any social media platform that you prefer, and to head to the links below to access more free materials that will help you impress anyone within a blink of an eye. Now, Francine sent in an email asking about first impressions as they relate to politics. Will your first impression affect voting decisions if you are running, for example, for a local office? And the answer is yes. Your first impression affects a decision everybody makes about you, whether you are a government official, a doctor, or a sales professional. It all comes back to those ABCs: your appearance, your behavior, and your communication. These are the major aspects that voters are going to base their first impression of you around. And if this is totally new for you, then head to this recent video, all about decoding first impressions. However, something that is important for you to remember is that nowadays, possibly the most important part of your first impression as a politician is your digital footprint. And here is why. First, the vast majority of voters or supporters will never have the pleasure of actually meeting you in person. Whether you are in a local office or the White House, voters will primarily be able to reach you and be reached and get a sense of your character through their screens. This means your website, your social media, your email campaigns, and any additional media exposure you have. Through these outlets, your voters will constantly be swamped with your posts, your photos, or your videos of you, where they will further be able to feel you out based on your appearance, your behavior, and your communication style. And if they aren't swamped with your digital impressions, chances are high they will from your opponent. So remember, anything that you are putting out there needs to be delivered in sound bites. Because first and foremost, time is an expensive asset, in particular online. People do not want to sit around and watch a long video. Rather, they want to know who you are as fast as possible. So put some thought into how you can send your core messages in quick, easy to digest, but impactful verbal and nonverbal messages. Think about where you can share your statements. They must be short, kind of tweetable, while still showcasing your core values. What are you going to do? And what do you care about? Tell a short story about it, be engaging, and above all, creativity is key. How can your stories be perceived without maybe even any words at all? Next, take some time to think about your image. I recently launched an image DNA assessment that tells you what your primary and secondary image personas are. Basically, you will learn how others perceive you based on your initial appearance. Your primary persona is how you naturally come off. Your secondary is what is still aligned with your true self and style while providing a different messaging behind it. Your image persona is important. For example, if you are running for a conservative party, you are likely wanting to appeal visually and verbally to a different group than you would if you were running for a more liberal party. This doesn't mean you should change who you are and the way you look, behave, or speak. Rather, that you should play with your secondary persona to send the subtle messages you are hoping to send to voters that identify with that persona. Because at the end of the day, voters prefer candidates with personality traits they would like to assign themselves. However, they hold you at a higher standard. Therefore, it's important to exaggerate your signals and, on top, to focus on competence. Competence is generally at the top of the list of the qualities voters look for in those who represent them. They want to know you will get stuff done, even that stuff they really don't fully understand themselves or want to understand in detail, and that you use your voice to represent them and their ideals. While most voters do not have the time or patience to judge your competence based on your tasks or achievements, they will take a shortcut. So how can you adjust your appearance, your behavior, and your communication so that your voters perceive you instantly as competent? While competence is perceived as the most important characteristic, keep in mind that this can change based on the situation or occasion your voters face. Not only that, a voter's perception of you is very dependent on their personal situation during your campaign period. That's why they also want to instantly feel that you care. You may be thinking, if everybody wants me to care about them and their personal problems, how will I stand for anything in particular? It's actually quite simple. Take care of yourself first, and this will show others that you have the capability to take care for them too. For example, if you do not keep yourself mentally and physically in shape, others will not feel they can rely on you as much. However, remember, when you are putting time and money into, for example, your physical appearance, that you sometimes need to be careful with, for example, luxury. While voters want somebody who is successful, they also will be looking at the brands and designers you are supporting, the coaches you are hiring, or the investments you are making into yourself. This can speak to your morals as well as put a price tag on you. Voters can use these price tags to make assumptions about how you will allocate financial resources if elected. As always, it's all about balance. And just as much as you are paying attention to yourself, pay attention to your opponent, because all the voters also have eyes on your opponent and how you are interacting with your opponent. The way you react to them, critic them, and attack them will all influence voters. So be mindful of what you are putting out there. Finally, remember that you are not a one-person team. The people on your political team and those in your personal life influence the way others see you, and therefore the chances if you are going to win this campaign or not. This is why you must stay extremely aware of how others' actions are impacting your image. This is to say, be careful of who you bring onto your team and potentially come to an agreement with your family, with your friends, and your campaign team members in order to maintain an optimal image for you together. I hope these pointers help you through the election, Francine, and to everybody else, remember that you too can have your questions answered. I'm here to support you along your journey, so don't be afraid to sign up below and submit your questions too. And thanks for watching. And don't forget to make your voice heard and vote.